Tonight, the former Dallas police officer who shot an unarmed neighbor in his own apartment is convicted of murder and now faces up to life in prison.
We, the jury, unanimously find the defendant, Amber Guyger, guilty.
The mother of the victim emotionally raised her hands as the verdict was read. Loud cheers after the judge delivered the news. Prosecutors pushed for the maximum conviction.
By God, in Dallas County, Texas, there will be a consequence for you walking in and shooting an unarmed, defenseless man.
Amber Guyger's lawyers say the shooting was an accident, that she was off duty for the night and entered the wrong apartment by mistake, the one directly above her own. Botham Jean, a 26-year-old accountant, was alone in that apartment when Guyger barged in and fired two shots, allegedly fearing for her life.
Whenever I fully opened the door, I saw this silhouette figure standing in the back middle apartment by the window.
Guyger testified she heard loud shuffling inside the apartment she thought was her own.
Why did you fire?
Prosecutors hammered Guyger for seeming more concerned about her own well-being than the victim's, that she didn't do everything she could to help him, never opening the first aid supplies in her backpack. Prosecutors also questioned why Guyger didn't just call for backup instead of using her weapon.
You could have called for help on your radio, and you could have had the cavalry there in 2 minutes.
I could have.
And had you done any one of those things, Mr. Jean would probably be alive today. Right?
Yes, sir.
The verdict is reigniting the debate over police violence and use of lethal force.
It's a signal that the tide is going to change here. Police officers are going to begin to be held accountable for their actions.
Black Lives Matter!
Black Lives Matter!
And energizing the Black Lives Matter movement.
This verdict is for Trayvon Martin, it's for Michael Brown, it's for Sandra Bland, it's for Tamir Rice.
Please remember the president's last remarks, that we are a great democracy. We are a great, the United States is a great democracy. And I'm airing what I'm airing because we are, in fact, a democracy. And if the press were straight and honest and forthright and tough, we would be a far greater nation. We would be a far greater when we don't have the CNNs of the world who are corrupt people. Thank you very much, everybody.
Yep.
Welcome to a special edition of The Lead, White House in Crisis. And you just saw there a president in clear crisis. I'm Jake Tapper. We have some breaking news. President Trump just now said that he will cooperate with House Democrats in their impeachment inquiry. They are warning the White House they will subpoena the White House for documents on Friday. We should note that the president also called the impeachment inquiry the greatest hoax, and he called it a fraudulent crime. So you can take his expression of willingness to cooperate as you will. President Trump also just accused Congressman Adam Schiff, the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, a Democrat from California, of helping to write the whistleblower complaint. We should point out that one of the whistleblower's lawyers who I just contacted, I just asked him, is there any truth that Schiff or the committee helped the whistleblower write the complaint in any way? And the lawyer said, quote, absolutely not. That was a response to a New York Times story on how the whistleblower had reached out to Congressman Schiff before filing the complaint.
So these two reporters wrote this book, and they said, I want a moat with alligator snakes, electrified fences, so people get electrocuted if they so much as touch the fence, and spikes on top. Never said it, never thought of it, and I actually put out something on social media today. I said, I'm tough on the border, but I'm not that tough. Okay, it was a lie. Just so you have it, you asked the question. It was a total lie. It was corrupt reporting, okay? I don't even use fake anymore. I call the fake news now corrupt news because fake isn't tough enough. And I'm the one that came up with the term. I'm very proud of it. But I think I'm going to switch it largely to corrupt news because the media in this country, not everybody, we have some great reporters, some great journalists, but much of it is corrupt. It's corrupt. You have corrupt media in this country. and it truly is the enemy of the people. Thank you very much.
Watching the President of the United States, a lengthy discussion with reporters there in the Oval Office. One of the challenges covering this president, especially at a time of an impeachment inquiry, is, it's a sad statement, but a true statement, the president constantly and repeatedly lies, including in that session you just saw right there. At the end, he was attacking two very professional New York Times reporters who just wrote a very good book on immigration. The president questioning that. He cooperated with that book. He sat down for an interview with the two reporters. Now he's trashing the book.
I want to play the sound because I do think it is so important that President Trump refused to answer this question. Because remember, first President Trump said this was a perfect call. Then the evidence came out from the White House that President Trump indeed asked the president of Ukraine to investigate his domestic political rivals, which many experts and authorities, including former Republican Congressman Charlie Dent on this show one day ago, said is a clear abuse of power. President Trump has said he did nothing wrong. Very few Republicans have been willing to come forward and say, oh yeah, this is absolutely fine. Here is Jeff Mason, an excellent and mild-mannered reporter with Reuters, asking President Trump, what did you want President Zelensky to investigate about former Vice President Joe Biden and his son Hunter? Take a listen.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, it was just a follow-up of what I just asked you, sir.
Listen, you ready? We have the president of Finland. Ask him a question.
I have one for him. I just wanted to follow up on the one that I asked you, which was,
did you hear me?
What did you want?
Did you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Ask him a question.
I will, but
I've given you a long answer. Ask this gentleman a question. Don't be rude.
In case of emergency, break glass, and the president of Finland is underneath that glass. But I mean, but why not answer the question if it's perfect, if there's nothing wrong with
it? Here's what's so remarkable, and I'm so glad you played that. We've all had experiences with the president, interviewing the president. Well, maybe not you, but most of us.
But I envy you so much.
And we've watched so many times when the thing about him is he always answers the question. Mm. The fact that he didn't answer that question is because he didn't want to.